Good morning, everyone. My paper presentation topic is ultrasonography and evaluation of breast lesions staged by BI-RADS in correlation with FNAC and histopathology. My co-authors are B. Panil Kumar, Professor MDRD, and Dr. Pradeep Kumar, Professor MDRD. Coming to introduction, sonography has become a standard breast imaging procedure during the last 15 years because of technological advances such as use of all high-frequency transducers up to 39 MHz and color and power Doppler imaging. My aims and objectives include evaluation of breast lesions using ultrasonography and classify them using ultrasound BI-RADS categorization to evaluate sensitivity, specificity, postoperative value, notoperative value, and accuracy sonography in differentiating malignant form benign lesions to determine the most accurate sonographic feature in differentiating malignant from benign lesions to correlate ultrasound features of breast lesions with FNAC and histopathology. My materials and methods include source of data from Department of Radiology, Shantra Medical College, Nandyal, and the duration of study is from October 2020 to January 2020, which includes 50 sample size. My sampling criteria include inclusion criteria, which is all patients with clinically palpable breast lesions or with suspicious lesions on mammography above 18 years of age are included, and follow-up of tissue diagnosis done during the duration of my study in this hospital are included. Coming to exclusion criteria, all patients with inflammatory breast lesions and patients whose sonological examination is inadequate or tissue diagnosis not available are those who lost follow-up. Coming to results analysis, this table shows distribution of patients according to age group. This table shows presenting symptoms. This table shows ultrasonographic findings. This table shows frequency of the shape of index mass lesions on ultrasonography. This table shows frequency of the margins of index lesion on ultrasonography. This table shows frequency of presence or absence of pseudocapsular index lesions. This table shows frequency of posterior echo intensity index lesions. This table shows frequency of echogenicity of the index lesions. This table shows frequency of microcalcifications in index lesions. This table shows frequency of flow characterization of index lesions on color Doppler. This table shows frequency of pattern of vascularization on index lesion on color Doppler sonography. This table shows frequency of resistive index lesion on color Doppler sonography. This table shows frequency of BI-RADS category of index lesions on ultrasound. This table shows calculation of p-value for ultrasound features. This table shows calculation of significance for BI-RADS. And this table shows results of comparison of BI-RADS with biopsy. And this table shows results of comparison of BI-RADS with FNAC. This table shows comparison of ultrasound features with FNAC and biopsy. This table shows histopathology for the final diagnosis of the index lesion. And this table shows histopathology and FNAC for the type of carcinoma in index lesions. This table shows comparison of ultrasound classification with the pathological findings in 50 breast lesions to detect malignant lesions. All 50 patients who underwent ultrasound examination were in age group of 19 to 55 years. A palpable breast lump was most common presenting complaint. Some patients had more than one complaint. Focal mass was the most common finding on ultrasound. Associated axillary lymph nodes were seen in 8 patients, 4 of which were seen in malignant lesions. All of the malignant lesions were hypoechoic. Majority of them showed irregular shape with spiculated margins and distal acoustic attenuation 63.6%. Majority of the benign lesions showed lobulated and oval shape. Echogenic pseudocapsule surrounding the lesion was seen in 25% of cases. Other benign sonographic features included hypoechoicity and smooth margins in 75% cases. On color Doppler sonography, color signals were seen in 90.1% of malignant and 28.6% benign lesions. Majority of them malignant lesions showed penetrating pattern of vascularization. Spectral Doppler analysis of breast lesions shows RI greater than 0.99 in 90% of malignant lesions and RI less than 0.99 in 87.5% of benign lesions. 11 malignant lesions were characterized as BI-RADS 5 and 13 lesions as BI-RADS 4 on ultrasound. Most of the primary tumors were infiltrative ductal carcinoma on histopathology, except 2 of them were medullary carcinoma on malignant phyllodes on mucinous secreting carcinoma. It is found that ultrasound is insensitive for the detection of index tumors. This is the case of medullary carcinoma. This ultrasonogram shows large hypoechoic mass lesion with areas of specs of calcification in the axillary tail of breast. Here we can see in the histopathological picture, syncytial pattern of anaplastic tumor cells with surrounding lymphoplasmocytic infiltrates. This is a case of fibroadenoma. This sonogram shows hypoechoic lesion with a smooth margin with few specks of calcification. The histopathological picture shows intracanalicular invagination of stromal connective tissue with increased stromal component. This is a case of intraductal carcinoma. This ultrasonogram shows hypochromous lesion in retroiliary region with angular margins. This lesion shows evidence of peripheral vascularity. This histopathological picture demonstrates cellular clusters of ductal epithelial cells with pleomorphic hypochromatic nuclei, which is seen in high-grade intraductal carcinoma. This is a case of fibroadenoma. On this sonogram, we can see well circumscribed mass lesion, which is heterogeneously echoic and has microlobulations with specks of calcifications. This histopathological picture shows increased evenly distributed glandular and stromal components. This is a case of invasive ductal carcinoma. Here we can see mass lesion with irregular margins and area of cystic lesion. Central and eccentric intracystic soft tissues are noted. This sonogram demonstrates evidence of peripheral vascularity with low resistance flow. This histopathological picture shows pleomorphic hyperchromatic nuclei within highly cellular ductal epithelial cells seen invading into the stromal tissue, seen in invasive ductal carcinoma. This is a case of invasive ductal carcinoma. The ultrasonogram shows ill-defined hypoechoic mass lesion with a microcalcifications and irregular margins is seen in breast. This histopathological picture shows pleomorphic hyperchromatic nuclei with high cellular ductal epithelial cells seen invading the stromal tissue arranged in sheets and cords. This is a picture of invasive ductal carcinoma. This sonogram shows hypoechoic mass lesion with angular margins. And also we can see large axillary lymphadenopathy in the left breast. This picture shows highly cellular ductal epithelial cells with pleomorphic hyperchromatic nuclei seen invading in the stromal tissue arranged in the sheets and cords. This is a case of medullary carcinoma showing hypoechoic lesion with penetrating artery. Restive index was seen more than 0.99. This histopathological picture shows large tumor cells in a syncytial fashion and are sharply separated from the surrounding stroma, which is heavily infiltrated by lymphocytes and plasma cells. This is a case of Pilot's tumor. This ultrasonogram shows large capsulated, smooth marginated hypoechoic mass lesion with multiple septations coated in the breast. This histopathological picture shows nodular structure with a prominent stromal proliferation in periductal ridges. This is a case of mucinous cystic adenocarcinoma. Here we can see fairly well-defined hypoechoic lesion in the right inner quadrant with a lobulated margin on the middle aspect of the lesion. This microscopic picture shows evidence of large glandular cells with extracellular holes of mucin surrounding aggregates of low-grade cancer cells. Coming to discussion, ultrasonography is used screening modality for screening of breast lesions. All patients suspected breast lesions should be subjected to ultrasound for initial detection and localization of lesion. The use of ultrasound morphological features in the present study obtained an overall sensitivity of 90.9% and specificity of 87.57% and positive predictive value of 83 and a negative predictive value of 92% for mammary lesions. My study was a sequential screening test in which cases were FNAC positive maintained for biopsy. Comparison of VOC with FNAC revealed a sensitivity of 78 and specificity of 77, and comparison of ultrasound with histopathological examination reveals sensitivity of 72 and specificity of 100%. To conclude, ultrasound is sensitive imaging modality for the evaluation of suspicious breast lesions. Ultrasonography helps to evaluate the disease morphology and extent better. It is recommended that ultrasonography be the initial screening tool in patients suspected to have breast lesions, followed by higher imaging modalities like contrast MRI for further characterization if indicated. This protocol helps the operating surgeon to give a maximum information about the lesion by also providing a roadmap prior to surgery. Coming to conclusion, this was a sequential screening test done as a prospect to study assess the diagnostic efficiency of the ultrasound in clinically and mammographically detected breast lesions to differentiate breast from malignant lesions and to determine the extent of primary breast carcinoma. All 50 patients underwent ultrasonography followed by histopathology or FNAC for final analysis. Ultrasound was performed using high frequency probe, that is 12 MHz on Philips IU22 equipment. Focal mass for the most common ultrasonography finding. Associated axillary lymph nodes were seen in 8 patients. All of the malignant lesions were hypoechoic. Majority of them show irregular shape, speculated margin and distal acoustic attenuation. Majority of benign lesions showed lobulated margin and oval shape. Echogenic pseudocapsule surrounding the lesion was seen in 25% of cases. Other sonography features include hypoechoicity and smooth margins in 75% of cases. On color Doppler sonography, color vascularity seen in 90% of malignant and 28% of benign lesions. Majority of malignant lesions showed penetrating pattern of vascularization. Spectral Doppler analysis of breast lesions showed RI greater than 0.99 and in 90% of malignant lesions and RI less than 0.99 in 87.5% of benign lesions. Based on Barrett's classification according to the American College of Radiology, breast lesions are characterized as benign, probably malignant and malignant. 11 malignant lesions were characterized as Barrett's 5 and 13 lesions as Barrett's 4 ultrasonography. These are my references. Thank you.